Hello, 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 my lovelies. It is Talk Radio's Freaky Fucking Fridays. I'm starting early. I figure you guys by now got acclimated with the platform. No need to be nice about it, dance around about it, whatever. Right? We're not waiting the 15 minutes or whatever normally. So this is Freaky Fridays. This is not the musical mix Essex we've had all week. That's been pretty tame. Yes, those archives are available for you to go and listen to if you'd like to. But tonight is all about the grown up stuff. That's why when the promo goes out, it says explicit adult content headphones are required. Hopefully with an exclamation point. So you guys get the point. Yes, it is Freaky Fridays this evening, you guys. We're going to dig into the email bags. I've not done that for you guys in a while. So I want to do that, get to catch up on some of the emails that have come in. What your crazy thoughts, what you're thinking, what you want some feedback on, and some advice from Cypher. So you are divinely connected and tuned into www.tawkradio.com/shows. I'm recording from the side of the road in New York City. You guys will hear cars passing me. Probably some sirens, maybe a couple of angry people. I don't know. I'm outside. It's hot. And if I put up the windows in the car and turn on the AC, it's going to be really loud and whatever. So we'll just rock with it. Unscripted, uncensored material here. So you guys, you know, rock. Now, somebody threw down a gauntlet at me and they challenged me to play more independent artist music. So I'm going to do it. We'll start the show off with two newies but goodies, right? And in the middle of the show, we'll start playing the independent artist music. We'll have some conversation tonight about reading the emails. I'm going to give you guys some follow-up information on the George Floyd murder, some things that came in, some headlines I want to read and get into, and we'll talk about some grown-up things. Tonight is Freaky Headline Fridays. The first hour of the show will be all of the debauchery. If this part is not for you, do something else and come back around 55 minutes from now, and we'll be talking about some other stuff, some headline news and things. I'll be sprinkling information in between. You never know what you're going to miss, so if you should really stay here, rock with me, be a part of this movement. www.tawkradio.com/shows. This is Talk Radio. I'm your hostess, Cypher Kai. The first one we're going to play this evening is going to be Omarion featuring T-Pain. Can you hear me? The explicit version, of course, on Talk Radio's Freaky Fucking Fridays.
I wanna capture the essence of being unbothered. Yeah. Hey, oh, yeah, yeah, hey.
I've been acting hella different lately. Can you hear me? Can't get my new number to my baby. Can you hear me? Got too much security, none of them bitches can't get near me. My mink be so furry, got them vultures trying to get me, ooh. My sheep be hella loud. Can you hear me, My sheep be hella loud. Can you hear me, I throw it in the crowd. Can you hear me, My sheep be hella loud. Can you hear me, Yo nigga don't like me, but he respecting me, feel me? He don't wanna see me mix that way, why with the Henny? Don't know why them people hating on me, they can't stand me. But can they have me? A couple Grammys, yeah. Talk that talk, cause I walk that walk. Niggas better watch my shoes. They be following me wherever I go. But you must know I got the news. Ball boss with the paint job. 4G auto with the shoes. MCM with the six pack. Baby daddy to your boo, yeah. I've been acting hella different lately. Can you hear me? Can't get my new number to my baby. Can you hear me? Got too much security. None of them bitches can't get near me. My mink be so furry. Got them vultures trying to get me, ooh. My sheep be hella loud. Can you hear me, My sheep be hella loud. Can you hear me, I throw it in the crowd. Can you hear me, My sheep be hella loud. Can you hear me,
My sheep be hella. I get a wetter than my acapellas. None of the niggas ever hit that better. They say she only with me cause I got that cheddar. But I come in and knock it down. You can never knock my crown. Ring later, baby, I'm not that clown. 20 minutes up, let it rock the ground. Can you hear me? That's your hoe, that's my hoe too, I'm commandeering. Ooh, Debbie's gonna do everything that I say, I call her Siri. Ooh, she gotta call me on my money phone, I'm just too busy for the cricket, baby.
I've been acting hella different lately, can you hear me? Can't get my new number to my baby, can you hear me? Got too much security, none of them bitches can't get near me. My mink be so furry, got them vultures trying to get me, ooh. My sheep be hella loud, can you hear me, My sheep be hella loud. Can you hear me, I throw it in the crowd. Can you hear me, My sheep be hella loud. Can you hear me,
talkradio.com's Freaky Fucking Fridays. You guys, I'm super hyper. So first of all, shout out to all of you who, that, oh my god, how many of you were on waiting 6 o'clock this evening thinking it was going to be a 6 o'clock show. Friday's show starts at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The musical mix at 6 is at 6 p.m. Not to confuse you, maybe going forward I'll fix that, but for now, that's what the time frame is. But we got a super VIP in the public chat room. Shout out to Miss Blue Ayado, that is in the public chat room with us. Hello, Miss Lady. How are you? She has a book out on Amazon called It Started in Brooklyn. Correct me if I'm saying that right. It Started in Brooklyn. You guys go and cop that on Amazon Books. Read something besides your Facebook posts. What the fuck? Giving you marching orders. Oh, hello. Mr. Ven is in the public chat room too. It's going to get saucy in here tonight. I can tell. I need you guys feedback on everything. Get super active tonight, right? Give me all your feedback on the music. The A&Rs want to hear what you guys are thinking. The fans want to know what you're thinking. And just know that people can see you guys in there, but even if they don't respond. So if I'm getting some things going on back, some information back and forth about you guys, profile pictures of people talking to you, I'll tell you what they're saying. So tonight it's all about the email extravaganza. I'm going to dig into the email bags and read some of the things you guys got coming in. I hope there's not a bunch of stories in there. Please, if you want to send your emails in, questions at tawkradio.com. 4 to 6 sentences maximum, please. Promise you by the fall we'll have the active phone lines open. You can call and talk to me about all your shit, but also know when you call in for that as well, there'll be a timer. I'll ding the fucking bell, you stop talking, then I'll ding it again, you stop talking. Let me give you some feedback. Swear to god, I will hang up on you. Just know that. And 30 seconds sounds like a little bit, but 30 seconds is a long time to speak. So get your things together. You can read and speak on the air on your own. 30 seconds. Coming in the fall. So we're going to continue here on this Freaky Fucking Fridays. As I get myself situated in this hot ass car on the side of the road in New York. The next one we're going to play here is going to be Road Timmy featuring Wale, In My Bed. God knows. I swear, I'm going to get myself some trouble at the end of this broadcast. I swear, because I'm going to find some trouble tonight. Find it. In My Bed, Road Timmy featuring Wale here on Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio.
Dinner removed, okay, we through, but I ain't finished yet. Can I slide with you? Yeah. Spend the night with you? Yeah. Just let me write and it keep dripping from my signature. I feel like your body inspired my intentions. Yeah. You left the squad hanging, it's only time with us. Yeah. You know I vibe different, cause you know my mind different. Her eyes say in my room, her body say in heaven, on God.
Tell me what you want, I go repeat. Tell me what you need, I go knee deep, yeah. When I fall in love, I go deep, deep, yeah. You can copy that like it's easy, yeah. You look like you need proper. Come get this vitamin D power, proper. Be ready to touch when I reach it, yeah. I go eat it up, I know vegan, yeah. I make that thing go wild. I go make that thing run water. I go make you sing my song. There's a meeting in my bed. In my bed. There's a meeting in my bed. In my bed. There's a meeting. Such a vivid if I'm way. Everything you need, no pop. Call me when you need top, top. I make that thing go wild. I go make that thing run water. I go make you sing my song. There's a meaning in my bed. In my bed. There's a meaning in my bed. In my bed. There's a meaning. In my bed, oh, na 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 na.
Radio's Freaky Fridays, Freaky Fucking Fridays here on talkradio.com with your host, Cypher Kai. It's all about the email extravaganza tonight, We're going to showcase the independent artist music. This is a live, uncensored, unfiltered, unapologetic platform if you're new to it. I mean, someone that really cares about you connected to the show. This is like a big secret, a big international, global, freaky, naughty secret. So somebody either really likes you a lot, or they want to shock you. They got some things they want to say to you, a conversation they need to have, and they're afraid to have it, and this is the platform where they can do it. So we appreciate having them here, having you here, you and your friends. I hope you guys got your glass of wine or some kind of liquor, something to smoke, something to mellow you out. You put your babies away and you're ready for the debauchery and the grown-ass conversations. As we continue here this evening playing some songs, we're going to start to move into, in a minute, some of the independent artist music that we're going to showcase in the middle of the show. But I'll knock out some of the signed artists first. This next one I'm going to play is going to be called You Too Love by Neo and Jeremiah here on Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio.
I don't want nobody else.
Radio's Freaky Fucking Fridays, Freaky Fucking Fridays. I'm debating. are wondering, now normally when we do the shows, we start the main topic around 8:30, right? To give people a chance to get settled, put their babies away, mother-in-laws away, turn the ringers off their phones, get themselves acclimated for grown-ass shit. But I'm looking through the headlines of these emails and my God, I can't wait to read these things for you guys. Jesus Christ. Love how your minds work. Love that you trust me. I'll continue. I'll play some more music. I'm going to calm down, you guys. But damn it. And if you're in the public chat room, if you have access to me behind the scenes on my private lines, if you want to give commentary, 347-651-2468. 347-651-2468. Also, facebook.com/TAWK radio. Need you guys to give me some feedback on this stuff. It's juicy. But as we continue here, the next song I'm going to play is going to be 11. This is Khalid featuring Summer Walker. I'm obsessed with this song. I have now become obsessed with this song. I'm really obsessed with everything I'm going to play tonight. But this one's a banger. And I want to be banging someone to it. This is Freaky Fridays, you guys. It's not going to get any better. I'm trying to be nice. It's still early in the show, but I'm trying to be nice. But I swear to you, we're grown and sexy here. Grown and sexy. 11, Khalid featuring Summer Walker here on Talk Radio's Freaky Fucking Fridays.
Got my headlights off, wishing outside. If you cry in my car, then we're here all night. A couple blunts rolled and I got my windows down. Shit, it's been a while since you've been this high. If you're waiting on love, that you're waiting for what? If your neighbors wake up, then we gotta turn it down. So you say I'm the type you like keeping around. You like keeping around. Late at 9-11, we're cruising. Lately, I've been watching your movements. If I'm the only one that you're choosing, am I your favorite drug you've been using? Late at 9-11, we're cruising. Lately, I've been watching your movements. If I'm the only one that you're choosing, am I your favorite drug you've been using?
Of time, if I'm waiting on love, I'll be waiting all night. I can't get this high from nowhere else, and I'm trying to let you go, but it's hard. I know I can't stay up on my feelings when I'm with you. I know I admit it, I'm addicted when I'm with you. Whenever I'm with you.
AWK, sorry guys, caught me by a couple seconds. Shit, I was doing something else. I'm sending out messages and doing all kinds of stuff, so I'm so sorry about that. I'm going to play two more songs before we dig into the email bags, because the debauchery is real. It's really, really real. If you guys want to give any commentary or give any shout outs, 347-651-2468. 347-651-2468 is the number to reach me here to do your shout outs and commentary. Unless you want to come into the public chat room and have some fun with Miss Blue Ayato and Mr. Ven and whoever else decides to jump in there, www.tawkradio.com/shows. In the player, there's a talking bubble. Click it. Follow it over, they'll give you some instructions on what to do. So there you go. That that song was Khalid featuring Summer Walker, 11. I want you guys to know the names of the songs so you can go and look them up, you know, and have a good time and have a good time. So we're going to continue on here. This one is called A Thousand Bad Times. Now, this one is a special shout out to the landlady. She requested it. I have no idea if she's on or not right now, but if she listens to the archive, she will hear it. All right, so there we go. So here we go. This one is A Thousand Bad Times by Post Malone here on Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio. AWK Radio, that was Mr. Post Malone, A Thousand Bad Times here on Talk Radio. We play all genres of music here. If you have music you want to showcase on the show, showcase, damn mouth again, not doing anything fun with it. I'm gonna start some trouble tonight. I swear I'm gonna start some trouble tonight. So after the show, I'm gonna start some trouble during the show too, because that's what I do. I start trouble and arguments here on Freaky Fridays. So we're gonna continue here. There's a special song I'm gonna play at the very end of the song, a throwback song that was requested by one of the super fans of the show. I'm gonna take it back all the way to 1986. I bet you guys can't guess what it is. Some of you weren't even living then. Good grief. Anyway, one more song before we hit that 8:30-ish mark and start digging into this email bag and all the things that are in there. So now we're gonna start that independent artist segment of the show, because we are grown and I believe in these artists, and they're fantastic and they're connected to the show, and so what and whatever, and these are exclusives, so whatever, right? This is where you get your papers and pens out. This is where you start taking down names and following them and adding talk radio under their social medias and all that other stuff, and giving me feedback on them as well. They want to learn, they want to grow, you know, they want to become better at their craft. And for those of you who appreciate it and like it as is, say that. They love to hear the feedback. It's really, really good for them. Young people just starting out. So this one is going to be Mr. Carson Luders. That's so vulgar. Swear, I said I'm outside on the side of the road, you guys. Forgive me. I hope you're still hearing me through all of these pretentious fucking guys in their loud-ass cars. So anyway, this one's going to be No Caption from Carson Luders here on Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio.
Waking up thinking about how we went last night, yeah. Young and I'm living it really like that, yeah. Imagine a bunch of pretty girls and a few of my guys. Imagine that, no caption. Don't gotta say it, I really live this life. Imagine that, take a picture of the frame, post up. No caption, take a picture of the frame, post up. No caption, you know I'm on the way, all the way. Just imagine that. No caption, you know I'm on the way, all the way. Ain't no way down with a feeling, just imagine that. No caption. I paint a picture, you know it's all HD, yeah. Ain't no decision, just come and leave with me, yeah. Imagine a bunch of your pretty friends and a few of my guys. No caption. Don't gotta say it, I really live this life. Imagine that. Take a picture of the frame, post up. No caption. Take a picture of the frame, post up. No caption. You know I'm on the way, all the way. Ain't no way down with a feeling, just imagine that. No caption. You know I'm on the way, all the way. Ain't no way down with a feeling, just imagine that.
WK Radio on this freaky fucking Fridays. Let's get it. Let's get it. Shout out to another super VIP on the air tonight, on the tongue stuck. Shout out to my daughter, my oldest baby girl, defiantly is tuned into Talk Radio. Now mind you, she's grown enough, right? She's having sex already. She's 25 years old and gorgeous. But I told her, no matter how old she gets, she's never old enough to listen. But she's on, and you know, just being Cypher's child, she let me know she's there, because she's bossy that way, right? So shout out to my big baby girl, who I think is tuned in with her lady. Yeah. She's ready for the email. She's so saucy. So shout out to Bingalina, my baby girl, who's tuned in right now with her lady, for the all of debauchery here on Freaky Friday's email extravaganza. All right, let's get into it. Let's freaking get into it. So who's telling me what naughty things in here, innit? All right, nice jam. It's all about the independent artists from here going forward to maybe like the last song for the show. All about the independent artists. I want to hear the feedback from you guys. But let's get into the bullshit. Let's start. Yes. All right. So this one says, my girlfriend was a slut. See, look it. How could I not read this? Right? Okay. So this is the first. Okay. I've been with her for over 6 months now. Everything was great, as it always is at the start of a relationship. We both were really happy, but now I learned something about her that's hard. I'm having a hard time dealing with. Apparently, as the title says, she was a slut. She had many, many random guys in her past. FYI, she's 24 and I'm 22. Since she was 17, at that time, she started having sex with just random different people. That's been going on for at least a year, although probably longer. Now, I just don't know what to do with that information, because while on the one side, I actually feel I could actually love her, this is just disgusting to me. I mean, everyone can do what they like, but the thought that she's got in bed, if they even made it to the bed, I wasn't inside some club or some bar with hundreds of guys, is something I have a hard time dealing with. Now I want to ask your opinion about this, Cypher. How would you react to that information? Do you think I'm overreacting? Because I'm seriously thinking about ending it with her. Oh, sweet baby Jesus. First of all, let me just start by saying thank you, Nicholas, for sending this in. Okay, let me start right there before I tear your whole entire fucking face off. Let me just start by saying thank you for sending that in. And before I give my feedback on this, 347-651-2468 is where you can send me commentary about this question and or anything that I'm going to say in rebuttal to this question or anything else that's coming up. If you don't have access to me on my private lines in the Facebook Messenger on facebook.com/TAWK radio or in the public chat room. So now with those disclaimers out, let's start. Nicholas, she's 24, you're 22. Look it. I'm going to say a lot about this. I'm going to give you some information first. What's my thoughts on this? Okay. At 20 something, at 20 something, she's doing exactly what she's supposed to be doing with her vagina. Yes? Now, you seem a bit ungrateful. I've got to tell you, you seem a little ungrateful. At 24, so her 24 means she's really like 30, because women are okay, older than guys, yeah? But the fact that you think you're in love with her, you know why that is? Because at 20 something, starting from 17 to 20 something, she did exactly what she's supposed to do, exactly what I instruct talkers to do. You're supposed to waste pussy, you're supposed to waste vagina responsibly to get to know your body, what you like, what you don't like, and to be a better lover for your future intended. Instead of thanking this woman for getting all this practice out before she met you, you're sitting there saying you can't unhear what she said. Now, here's the thing then. When you are an adult, you don't ask questions you don't actually want answers for. Because I don't know what you were expecting to find out. If this girl is fantastic in bed, I'm assuming. Because if you think you're in love with her at 20-something, she's got you sprung out. People are not usually in... At 20, you start to be in love with teenagers. 20-something, you're kind of like lusty, infatuated. You don't really fall in love to like 20-something. When you really understand the concept of what it is. So she got your wit. And you should be thanking her again for all that pussy she was wasting on these hundreds of guys before she got to you. Yes? What would I do with this information? Look it. If this guy tells me his body count, yes? It's like a couple hundred thousand people. A couple hundred people. My first instinct would be, okay, well, that's a good thing. Let's check you out. Once he comes back and those tests are clean, those STD checks are clean, the blood work is clean, and he's there throwing the dick properly, I'm thanking him. Fuck, and depending on what technique he uses and what angle he puts me in, I might want to, you know, give homegirl a shout out too. Like, yo, do you remember her phone number? Can you fucking put her on three ways? I can thank her too. Like, you know what I'm saying? And I say this because that's a thing that actually happens. I have, swear to God, hand to God, have had someone that I bust down. One of the four people I've bust down, we're going to talk about that in a minute, right? That I've bust down back in the days has called me with his baby mother on the phone. And she was thanking me for what she had just received because he told her, as he's supposed to tell her, when I say I want to be those women in those stories, in those fuck me well stories, he's supposed to tell her. And she says, oh my God, do you have her number? And they called me, hand to God, they called me. And she thanked me. Matter of fact, they were in the middle of an argument. And he was like, listen, you know, you don't cut your bullshit, I'm not going to give you. She's like, what? And I was on the phone with him. I had to call, hey, what you doing? Out of the blue, just like, hey, what's up, phone call. And she gets on the phone, she goes, oh my God, you're a real person. And she's thanking me for all the great cock she's gotten from that man, courtesy of my teachings all these years. That's an actual thing. That's an actual factual here on Talk Radio. You heard it here first. I have storytelling vagina. Just going to fucking say. Now, further than that, though, here's a rule of thumb. Guys, okay, ladies. Somebody sent me a video before. I didn't get to watch the whole video, right? But I'm going to give you some mathematics. This is where you get your papers and pens out. Learn some new arithmetic. Yes? Women. Over a certain age. I want to say over 30. Ladies over 30. Yes? No matter how many conquests you've had, no matter how many people you've been with, let me teach you how to do the mathematics for your body count, because guys seem to get offended by body count. You could be 50 years old, and Lord knows, if you tell them that you started fucking at 20 and you've had 30 partners, so then one each year for those 30 years, they would lose their mind. So here's how you do the count. Yes, if you've got children and they've got different fathers, and this is a known fact because maybe the father's interacting with them, you've got to count each of those guys independently. But any person you've slept with the same name counts as one person. So if you fucked five Michaels, all those five Michaels are one guy. Right? Yeah, one fucking guy. Also, your first love gets his own separate column. So whoever you fucked first gets his own counting. So the first guy you fucked, all of your baby fathers, right? The individual ones. And then everybody with the same name gets one counting. And no matter if you end up going, but you never go past double digits with this number. Never. Right? So even if you say, okay, well, I had three Johns, two Bobs, a couple Michaels, and some da-da-da-da, the number stops before you get to double digits. That's a rule, right? So let's write that shit down. Let's do it again, right? This is your math. This is your body count math for insecure men. That's what we're calling it. The body count math for insecure men. Okay? So your first, the first one that got to bust it through, right? The willing one. So if you were like molested or whatever, you don't count them. We're not talking about them, right? The first one you willingly gave it to gets its own number, right? Then the kids' fathers get their own numbers, right? And then anybody with repeating names is counted as one person, right? This goes for my rainbow community as well. If you fucked a couple Stacys, a couple Michelles, they all count as one. It all counts as one, because your partner's gonna start thinking, oh my God, you made how many people's vaginas or how many people's pussies feel like this? No, don't let her fret. Don't worry about it. Count as one. Same thing for you. So if you don't have any children, you can do less people on your math. Maybe your math stops at 4 or 5. Don't worry about it, right? But that's how the body count math goes. That is arithmetic for insecure mates. That's what that is. On Talk Radio mathematics. That's what that is. So that is my response to that question. What would I think about that? I'd be thanking if the sex was good, I'd be thanking my partner for knowing to get all that experience before he came and wasted some cock on me. That's my direct response to this question. This is Freaky Fucking Fridays on Talk Radio, if you just tuned in. Just going to let you know. We're going to play some more music and then come back with some more emails on this email extravaganza part 5. Here, if you want to give any commentary, 347-651-2468. 347-651-2468. The next one we want to play here is called Beast Mode by Leah Wynn, a Talk Radio exclusive on Freaky Fucking Fridays.
Russ, let me talk to him. Yeah. Yeah. Badass with an attitude.
Attitude.
Yeah. Leah Wynn. Uptown, boogie down, Bronx, bitch.
Uptown.
Nigga, don't forget it again. Heard all these bitches wanna fuck with me now. Nah, keep that same energy. CEO, head honcho, and press president. Whenever you addressing me, two-seater skirt skirt in my whip. Chop the top like I'm showing off my tits. Got a crazy nigga that'll pop pop with a clip. When it hits the target, I hop scotch on a dick. Man down, you're not about the action. You're renowned. Calm my vibes, they hate when I come back around. Make a hot head ho, simmer down. And they know it now, bitch. Number one next to you, zeros. Call me a 10. I am God's and the next to you, weak hoes. Look at my flex, yeah. I will always be lethal. Why they so vexed? Word to me that I'm going beast mode. that's why they fret. Yeah. If a bitch try to get loco, on our face, Timberland logo. Don't let up until we see Rojo. Say no names, no more free promo. Shh. I said what I said. You imagine nigga all in my DMs. He know this pussy top tier. He wanna eat it, then leave with me all in his beard. You don't compare, I make him bust quick. Pussy so fat, look like a tuck dick. Waist on snatching thighs is dumb thick. Eyeliner sharp and cut a bum bitch. Shaking in their denim, cause I'm spitting words like venom. Leah got these hoes feeling paranoid, but with no delay, this switch your blade, turn your face and your J's to some corduroys. Number one next to you, zeros. Call me a 10. I am God's, and the next to you, weak hoes. Look at my flex, yeah. I will always be lethal. Why they so vexed? Word to me that I'm going beast mode. That's why they fret, yeah. Number one next to you, zeros. Call me a 10. I am God's, and the next to you, weak hoes. Look at my flex, yeah. I will always be lethal. Why they so vexed? Word to me that I'm going beast mode. That's why they fret, yeah.
It's Lil Wayne. I know they really mad now. They like really motherfucking mad, you know? Killing these hoes. They like, I know they mad at feeling up. I know they mad at singing bitches really fucking killing them. Nah, let me stop. I'm done on these niggas.
TAWK Radio, TAWK Radio with your host, Cypher Kai, on Freaky Fucking Fridays, the email edition part 5. Okay, what is going on here? Oh, hello. Hello, Miss Niani here in the public chat room. What's hilarious? Oh, God. Okay, there's a lot of things. Oh, my God, I miss a lot of stuff in here. What's happening? What's happening? All right. Dude, rap with it. How many women have you been with? Right, he didn't mention how many women he's been with. This is in the public chat room, you guys. If you guys want to come into the public chat room and have a conversation with these lovely people in here, look in and see what they're saying. www.tawkradio.com/shows. In the player, there's a talking bubble. Click it gives you instructions. All right, so overreacting sis, calm down. Who's overreacting? I don't know who's overreacting. She's stupid. The most people any grown woman ever slept with is 4, no matter the real number. I love it. She said 4 people, that's it. Blue Arada said 4 fucking people. No matter how many people you've been with, the number's 4. Amen, okay? Okay. Because she knows what she's doing. That's why she got him hooked. Okay, oops. That's why I speak the truth, Miss Niani. Okay. And then you wonder why I can't believe what women say. Now look it. It's not about but not believing what women say then, damn it, okay? It's just, look it, do you actually want to know your lady's body count? No, you don't really. Because then you start thinking to yourself, do I measure up? Is she still, if her sex drive is that high, is she still screwing other people? You know, you start to feel a little emasculated, especially if as a man, when you guys are prided by your sexual prowess, if her body count is higher than yours, right? And since we're not regarded the same way as, oh, she's that bitch, it's like she's that slut, whatever, we're trying to get our pussy tweaked up for you too. You're welcome. And Bob's your uncle. I'm just saying, you fuckers. So you can never handle the body count. You guys never can. You should have given this math to my girlfriend before she told me her actual number. Okay, did she traumatize you, Miss Niani? Jesus Christ. Oh my. I don't give out numbers because that's none of her business. Well, how do you learn? Okay. Yes, indeed. The person who sent the email was overreacting. Okay, very good. So your girlfriend told you her body count, huh? Okay, love it. Shout out to my rainbow community has tuned in here to the show right now. Okay, so I'm gonna play another independent artist song. I tell you guys, live, unscripted, uncensored, we're having fucking fun here like grown-ups. Okay, we are. So I'm gonna play another independent artist song, and then I'm gonna go into the email bag and pull some more stuff, and we're gonna have some grown-ass discussions tonight here on Talk Radio's Freaky Fridays. This one is called Drive the Boat, here on Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio.
She feeling me and I'm feeling her too. All my music, she digging the shit.
She digging my
we tried to Netflix and chill her to doom, and she just started sucking the dick.
I had to throw some niggas off the boat, cause ain't nobody sinking my ship. I let her ride the boat just like she Megan Thee Stallion, she working them hips. She wanna drive the boat, I let her ride the boat. She got a front hitting boat, cause this ain't no paddle boat. She tried to go down, she whipped out my man, she said, you gotta lie to boat. Now she wanna drive the boat, I let her drive the boat. I let her jump on the boat like she Megan. Ain't no pulling out, I'm shooting like Steffin. She think I'm coming first, girl, what you betting? I pop a perk and said, it got me legging. Yo, bitch, she going down, young jock. Shawty, she still going, but it pop. She said her boyfriend locked up. Fucking this bitch while he fucking the sock. Look, shawty a big old freak. She put my name on them big old cheeks. These niggas skinny like he don't eat. Think I'm a plum, I'm fixing her leak. I get the head just to make sure her brain work. Tried to get me to eat it, it ain't work. I was hitting the teacher from Wise High School. Gave me an A, told me great work. I got the key to the streets, Lucci. Fuck designer, boy, I'm done wearing Gucci. I'm the pilot, got the key to the boat. Cut off my homie, I hope he can float. Give her a plan B, don't panic. Bitch, you ain't going out like Titanic. I see it up on my body, I'm throwing him on the boat. Then drop him off in the Atlantic. She feeling me and I'm feeling her too. All my music, she digging the shit. We tried to Netflix and chill her to doom, and she just started sucking the dick. I had to throw some niggas off the boat, cause ain't nobody sinking my ship. I let her ride the boat just like she Megan Thee Stallion, she working them hips. She wanna drive the boat, I let her ride the boat. She got a front hitting boat, cause this ain't no paddle boat. She tried to go down, she whipped out my man, she said, you gotta lie to boat. Now she wanna drive the boat, I let her drive the boat. She pulled me in the room, she just started riding. Shorty, she thick like she come from the islands. Hit it, she stalking me, calling my name. When she see me, Tiana Taylor calling Byron. Pull up with work, they like, what's in the box? She from Jamaica, I'm pulling her locks. Got this baby mama driving the boat. Disrespecting, getting thrown off the dock. Shorty fat, her booty big like a yacht. Stay with my gun, and it's litty, it's hot. We on the block, beating up the pots. You in the house, laying on your back. Told me pull up, I kick push like I'm Lupe. I got some Henny, Patron, and Deuce. Listen to me, she don't care about what you say. Play with the gang, I'ma aim at your toupee. Got a bag and fix my teeth like I'm Cardi B. Mommy, she happy, she proud of me. Net worth, say, 33 million. Google, why the hell you lie to me? I'm about to buy me a boat, then buy me a boat, then buy me a boat. She wanna ride the boat. Put her head back, then I look at her throat. She feeling me and I'm feeling her too. All my music, she digging the shit. She digging my shit. We tried to Netflix and chill her to doom, and she just started sucking the dick. I had to throw some niggas off the boat, cause ain't nobody sinking my ship. I let her ride the boat just like she Megan Thee Stallion, she working them hips. She wanna drive the boat, I let her ride the boat. She got a front hitting boat, cause this ain't no paddle boat. She tried to go down, she whipped out my man, she said, you gotta lie to boat. Now she wanna drive the boat, I let her drive the boat.
TalkRadio.com's Freaky Fucking Fridays. Freaky Fucking Fridays. Let's get it. All right. So now I have a whole lot of my radio, rainbow community tuned in and live and popping and letting me know you guys are there. I want to shout out to Augustine and April, who are tuned in from Minneapolis, Minnesota. They said the community over there is small, but they love being on Talk Radio. There's also some gentlemen that were tuned in earlier in the week from Tulsa, Oklahoma. I can't remember their names right now, but they said it's a very, I keep telling you, I believe there's much more people in this rainbow community than you guys know about. I'm telling you, they haven't come out the closet yet, but I'm telling you. So this one here says, how to get over a straight girl or not. Right? I am a female bisexual and I've been with girls and guys. I have never dated a girl, and it is harder for me to navigate my feelings for girls in general. I have a friend that I am starting to develop feelings for. I have known her for about 5 years. I haven't developed a crush on her for a seemingly straight girl yet, because I know the heartache that comes from that. However, despite all the warnings, here I am. I can't help it. She's great and I really want to date her. She identifies as straight, but every time we drink, we make out, among other things. This has happened multiple times. Anytime it's happened, it has been her coming on to me. This is a recurring thing and doesn't come from nowhere. Based on my conversations with her about her sexuality, I think she would sleep with me but not date me. I don't think this is healthy for me at this point in my life, but I really like her, and if I am drunk, who knows what will happen. I have gotten to the point of flirting with her, but I don't think she picks up on it. Again, I'm horrible with girls in general. So here I am. Should I just let her figure out her sexuality on her own? Should I just get from her what I can, even if it will hurt my feelings in the long run? What if I pursue her and it all works out in the end? Should I just tell her how I feel, even if she could push me away and be grossed out? I don't have any experience with these situations. I would appreciate some help. Okay, look it. My rainbow community, if you're there, you want to say something about this. Overall, that was more than 4 to 6 sentences, but it caught my attention, so I read it. So she's pretty much saying, look, she's she identifies as bisexual, as a female. She's been with girls and guys, but she seems to have a thing. She seems to have fallen for, gotten a crush on, fallen enamored with a straight girl or someone who identifies as straight. And when they get drunk, they'll make out, they'll do naughty things. And then afterwards, you know, nothing. But she really wants to be with this chick. Now, I'm going to say what I think just from the way my mind works. She's using you, and she pretty much said so. She kind of knows it, right? I don't even think this is a situation of this woman being in the closet. I just think she's greedy and selfish. I think she knows that you have a thing for her. I think you satiate her sexual urges. Your tongue game is probably off the fucking charts. And the fact that she pretends to get drunk, because she doesn't need to be drunk to that you have some, but she wants to justify it in her head. Could she be potentially self-deprecating at the fact that she allows these homosexual situations to happen, maybe, but she's still enjoying them? And so all of a sudden now she needs to be drunk to have it happen, because if she's allowing you to do more things than kiss her, this is not just kind of like a, oh, I'm curious kind of thing. She's getting nuts off, I'm sure, right? Full-on orgasms are happening. She's getting nuts off. She's using you. So pursuing her, if it's something that you enjoy as well, do it. You know what I'm saying? But don't pursue anything with your heart. It's not going to go anywhere. She's effectively told you that. She won't be with you when she's allegedly sober. She's letting you know that she identifies as being straight, even though she's having sexual situations with you. So yeah, if it's fun for you and you can detach your emotions from it, do it. If not, leave her be. Not for you. So how to get over a straight girl? Stop fucking sucking her cooch. Pretty much. Stop sucking her cooch. That's it. That's how I feel. But if anybody else wants to give me feedback on this, 347-651-2468. 347-651-2468. So somebody else is saying, I'm not a lesbian and I'm not a doctor. However, I have dated people. She's giving you incredibly mixed signals and you're in a situation fueled by alcohol. She gets to blame the spirit, and for you, it confuses you. Getting smashed is not a great way to navigate any sort of relationship. Think of it like driving. It is safer all around for you to have your wits about you. Very true. Very true. Yep. I agree. I agree on that. You guys are so all intellectual and junk. Love you. She's straight. You're not. Leave this girl alone. You literally can't be with her. Case closed. Next caller. And okay, so then you're saying go for it. Okay. Oh no, you're saying this is for something else. Do this and the email needs to chill out. Like Niani said, she hooked him using what she learned. If she just lay there. Okay, I can't read all this right now. But okay, so who are you telling to go for it then? The young lady, or are you telling the bisexual girl to go for the straight girl? That sounds like a bunch of heartbreaking setup though, doesn't it? It really does. Then you're wicked. What? Then that's not nice. Yes, that's not nice. All right. So this next question says, can stopping masturbation be bad? Okay. I want to stop masturbating and watching porn just to kind of reset myself as a human being and just to see if I can overall benefit from it. But I'm wondering if stopping could negatively affect my sex performance. I understand masturbation can help build stamina and things along that line. Would stopping be a negative towards having sex? Well, shit. Well, look it. I'm a big advocate of masturbation and blowjobs. Depends on how often you're masturbating. You didn't mention that. How often are you masturbating? I mean, if you're doing it like once a day, or once or twice a week, then no. If you find yourself, because I had gone through this myself. I think I've told this story on the show before. I've been celibate for a long time. And in the beginning, in the infancy of my celibacy, I used to masturbate a lot. Usually when my children were at school. And I remember getting to a point where it was happening so often, I used to get frustrated when I had to go pick them up from school. I was like, fuck, it's 3 o'clock already? You know, so if you're in a situation where you're like putting off other things, or your level of pistivity, make up words here, is elevating because you can't get to do it, then yes, you might want to reset yourself as a human being, right? Because then you won't really get any sexual gratification when you're having sex, because you're so accustomed to doing it yourself, and you'll be wondering why shorty's taking so fucking long to get you where you need to go. That's my personal take on that. There are some other people throwing some feedback here. What are they saying? What are you guys saying? Since I've always believed there is no such thing as a dumb question, I'm going to give you this answer, even though I consider this question the one that disproves my belief. Really? Don't be like that. Come on, you. God damn it. All right. I try to speak only from personal experience, so that's why I had to reframe the question answering. Okay. You waiting for the bigger picture? You guys are such assholes back here. I swear to God. So someone's saying, no, it helps to build the muscles in your penis. And that's always a good thing. Gives you better erections, blood flow, all that stuff. So, okay, those are the answers I'm getting for that particular one so far. Should you stop masturbating? Yeah, I knew how to get rid of your ass. There you go. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. This is why I tell you don't listen to the goddamn show. Okay, out of all the actual queer people you can choose from, you settle for a person who don't actually want you. Child. Okay. Okay. And now, yes, this young lady's leaving the chat room because the show's become too much. That happens from time to time. Gets a little overwhelming. This is a very grown-ass show here on Freaky Fridays. We're going to continue with some independent artist music. As we're coming up on this 9 o'clock hour, I did need to update you guys on some things that we discussed. I think I might have given you guys some fake news last week that I need to give you some updates on, so we'll correct it. I have no ego tripping here in correcting it. This next song, though, is going to be from Keisha Martin called So Good here on Talk Radio's Freaky Friday.
From me, cause the love where him I get is so good.
So no boy can't take me from my baby. Cause the love in him I get is so good.
And no girl can't take my man from me. Cause the love where him I get is so good.
Wine. Wine.
TAWKRadio.com's Freaky Fucking Friday. Freaky Fucking Fridays. Sorry, you guys. I'm doing some things behind the scenes. So, yes. Yes, 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 and yes. It's that 9 o'clock hour. And you guys are enjoying the email so much. So, here we do. I usually take this time to start talking about headline news and things that came up. What I'll do is update you guys on some information that I need to correct from, I think, 2 weeks ago. Because, like I said, I'm not above doing that. This platform is about giving out proper, correct information, about giving you guys things to talk about, look up, feel the need to question, and all of these things. 2 weeks ago, I believe, I started to talk about the George Floyd murder in the video that I saw, my perception of what I saw as an empath, as a clairaudient, as someone with a platform, what I was thinking and feeling as a black woman. And the mother of a black son. And so in that conversation, I believe that I had mentioned that it was brought to my attention. Seems to be inaccurately. Don't have the interns here to confirm it. But there's some people that reached out to me from Derek Chauvin's wife's lawyer's circle. Very respectfully. They weren't threatening me with anything or whatever. They wanted to clear up some rumors that was going around on social media. They wanted some help doing that. So I'm going to read what was sent to me. You guys can feel the need to look this up if you'd like. Okay. So they're saying... All right. So I had mentioned, because it was brought to my attention, and apparently it's been going around a lot, that the Asian officer that was standing next to Mr. Derek Chauvin, the gentleman that killed George Floyd, was related to the brother of Derek Chauvin's wife. Now, Derek Chauvin's wife is Laotian, and it was brought to my attention in flying around the place that the officer who was standing there was her brother. Well, that's not the case, as I was wondering. I seemed a little strange. It's like a conflict of interest. I know family members and people you sleep with are not supposed to be partners, but whatever. So they had said to me that I don't know how to pronounce the guy's name. Tu Thao is not Ms. Chauvin's brother. I would greatly appreciate help putting that rumor to rest. Amanda Mason Secular, her divorce lawyer, said in an email. Her family has been harassed and threatened based on multiple incorrect reports. So, Kelly Chauvin, who competed for the title of Miss Minnesota in 2018 with the hope of becoming the first Laotian winner, does have a brother, but it's not Thao. Her brother is a police officer in St. Paul, said Mason Secular, adding he was not involved in any aspect of Floyd's death. So his wife, Kelly Chauvin, does have a brother on the Minneapolis Police Department, but he was not involved with this whatsoever, and her brother is not the gentleman who was in the video with Derek Chauvin when he killed George Floyd. So, apparently a little bit of fake news, right? So I wanted to clear that up for you guys here in this 9 o'clock hour of Talk Radio, because we like to do that. We want you to have accurate information. Also, something else that had hit my timeline. There's a couple of things that hit. I got to go pull those up and look for those in a second. The plot thickens, though. It does. I wanted to give some homage to Jeff Bezos, the owner and founder of Amazon, did something very impressive this week that I want to discuss. So I'm going to go find that article in a second and pull it up. I'm going to read an email that was sent to him from someone, and what his rebuttal to it was really, really impressive. So I want to give that good news here tonight on the show as well. And then there's been a lot of you millennials have been making such a great difference in what you've been doing. And I want to shout out the millennials who got your head screwed on right. Not the ones who've been out there looting Prada bags and shit from Macy's and setting cars on fire, but the ones of you who went outside with your mask and your attitude and your words and you're getting things done. So in that vein, there is an article that also had hit my email a couple times about some protesters that took over a certain part of Seattle. and that's really prevalent. And I want to read it properly, say what they did, but more importantly, I love to give light to these Caucasian people who are stepping up in a way that's just very impressive. I don't know if it's white guilt, I don't know what it is that got you doing it, but god damn it, I'm feeling it. We're going to talk about it here on the show. I'm going to unofficially dub the mayor, I believe it's the mayor, she wasn't the governor, the mayor of Seattle, West Indian. And you guys will see why, right? When I find this article and come back and read it, you'll see why. But she's unofficially been dubbed West Indian. Yes, in this moment, I've decided to do that. We're going to continue here with the Sober Junkie here on Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio.
You and me both been through similar things. And somehow I know, you know I can feel your pain. But sometimes we get lost along the way. And a day might feel like rain, but luckily I know a way to a brighter day. Brighter day, gon' take me away. 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 Getting so high, getting me so low. I fell in love with the rush and nearly lost my soul. No destination, nowhere to go. I didn't care if I was broke, didn't care if I was cold. Getting high, trying to escape these lows. You might see me and panic. I know you don't understand me, but we have way more in common. Cause we both got some problems. You and me both been through similar things. And somehow I know I can feel your pain. But sometimes we get lost along the way. And a day might feel like rain. But luckily I know a way to a brighter day. Brighter day, gon' take me away. I've been down, I've been low. I've been places nobody should go. I've seen things no one should never. I've been to my lowest low. I felt I had no place to go. Now I'm on my knees, I'm begging you, save me. You see me and you panic. I know you don't understand me, but we got way more in common. Cause we both got some problems. You and me both been through similar things. And somehow I know, you know I can feel your pain. Sometimes we get lost along the way. And a day might feel like rain. But luckily I know a way to a brighter day. Brighter day, gon' take me away.
Okay, you guys, this is Freaky Fucking Fridays, Freaky Fucking Fridays, the headline portion of the show. I promise I'll get back to the emails in a minute, but there's a couple of things that I wanted to do. So like I said, I wanted to clear up that article that I read, my commentary that I gave 2 weeks ago, when I was given information that I thought was accurate and was being brought to my attention very respectfully, and they asked for some assistance. Kelly Chauvin's legal team wanted to set the record straight that her brother and Kelly Chauvin, if you're just logging onto the show, Kelly Chauvin is Derek Chauvin's wife or soon to be ex-wife. This is the police officer that killed George Floyd by kneeling on his throat for over 9 minutes. They wanted to get some help in setting the record straight. No one seemed to want to give accurate information. We do give accurate information here. And again, I don't tell stories here for ego purposes if I make a mistake. I love to make a correction because I want you guys to have accurate information and to carry on conversations after you hear the show. Maybe you'll learn something new the first time that you encounter the show. Now, I was correct in my assessment when I looked at the video to say that not only was there a connection that seemed personal between George Floyd and Derek Chauvin, but also it seemed of a sexual nature. And then only to find out after the fact, after I made that assessment, it came out that they worked together at a strip club. There was tension between them. And I was sent a porn video of George Floyd fucking someone very well endowed and doing a very good job at doing it, I might say. And so, yeah, I can kind of see where there would have been an issue there with him potentially banging a bunch of the strippers and then talking about his cock game. Just gonna say. Don't know that's what the cause of the contention was, but I could see how that could have been a thing. I'm just saying. We're grown round here. So now, let me give the Caucasian corner. Let's call it the Caucasian corner here on the show, right? So there are two people I'd like to give some love and some spotlight to this week in the Caucasian corner, because all lives matter. They do, right? And I don't want the fans of the show who are lighter complected to feel left out and alienated. This is not about vilifying anyone. It's just about what's happening, giving information, all that kind of stuff. Yes. So Mr. Jeff Bezos, I'm a fan of him. I will go into further detail about that another time. I won't do it right now, but I am a fan of Mr. Bezos, have been for a long time, for a reason that you guys won't even believe until I tell you. But anyway, and no, I've not slept with him before you guys thought your bullshit. No. Healthy respect. So Mr. Jeff Bezos got an angry email from an All Lives Matter customer. Hopefully they put the email here. Did they put it here? Okay, so let me read the article. It's not long, right? No, short one. Okay, here we go. So Amazon's, let me give proper credit to the person that wrote it. Hold on, I have to do that properly. Okay, Mr. J. Peters, Instagram post, yes? All right, so Mr. Bezos, Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos issued a public pledge of support to the Black Lives Matter movement on Friday. The chief executive did so in reply to a customer email criticizing his company's response to the death of George Floyd and ongoing protests around the country against racism and systemic police brutality. Bezos posted his reply publicly on Instagram. Right now, Amazon.com has a prominent Black Lives Matter banner at the top of the page that links to a blog post describing actions the company is taking to support Black communities and racial justice. The customer took issue with the banner, saying it is quite disturbing to get on the Amazon website and see Black Lives Matter. The customer later said that all lives matter, a common right-wing refrain used to criticize the Black Lives Matter movement. Black Lives Matter doesn't mean that other lives don't matter. Black Lives Matter speaks to racism and the disproportionate risk that Black people face in our law enforcement and justice system, Bezos said in his part of his reply, right? So his actual reply, let me see if I can find it. All right. I want to read his proper response. What did he say? Damn it, this is not the right piece. Well, anyway, he effectively said, look it. I support this movement. All lives matter, but Black lives also matter to me. I'm going to find it properly. I'm going to play a song and come back because I love what he said specifically. It was so profound. And the fact that he has such a huge platform and now as counting to Forbes billionaires list, he's officially the wealthiest man in the entire world, past all the oil sheiks and everybody else. And the fact that he's unashamed, unapologetic and supporting this movement is huge and speaks a lot about his character as a person and as a businessman. So, but I want to find the proper thing that I had that gave his proper response to this person, right? So I want to say it properly. I'm going to play some more music here for you guys on the show. Come back after I find that, hopefully, and we'll discuss what he actually said in response to that. So this is King Zoe featuring Ice Billion Berg. This is very explicit, you guys. Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio.
Cubans on my neck, you can tell I'm getting paid. Drop the top on them hoes, all this ice, I don't need shade. Hypnotized by them blades while I'm creeping down the block.
9 on my lap cock, AK in that trunk, bitch. Chop me if you won't, jit. My vibe don't interrupt it. Can I live? Can I chill? Sip and spin in the wheel. Ain't trying to do the dash, we ain't got no need to rush. Roll through, start up a fuss. Hating niggas, we stay with us. Laughing while we feel like
cuss. All I ever wanted was a 7-track. Seven track. All I ever wanted was a 7-track.
Dade County street dream came true, ooh wee. Never pressed about speed, I wanted to drive to the Keys. 4-5 on the seat, AC on freeze. Real leather, no leather, paint wet as the sea. The young niggas in the forest, they ain't second to me. Trump beating, the people on my street ain't getting no sleep. Because of this Chevy, my neighborhood forever know me. A real nigga coming through, old school and Paula Coupe. Swoop in the back window, feeling like my Uncle Moose. A game changing, lane changing ass nigga named Billy. I might go put the motherfucking stars in the ceiling. Going hard on callers, leave it parked for the pictures. And fuck these niggas, shit, I dropped it for the bitches, nigga. What?
All I ever wanted was a 7-track. Seven track. All I ever wanted was a 7-track. Seven track. All I ever wanted was a 7-track. Seven track. All I ever wanted was a 7-track. Seven track.
TAWK Radio, TAWK Radio. I am trying to find his response. I got all kinds of things popping in my face, you guys. Bear with me on the side of the road because he was so dope. His response was like so savage and I loved it. Where is it? Damn, can't find it. Not finding it, but you guys feel free to Google it. I'm giving you some homework. I'm giving you some talk radio homework. Go and Google Jeff Bezos' reply to an angry racist customer, because he was just so impressive in what the fuck he said. And I really wanted to read it clearly, because he made a comment about, I don't even want to fuck it up, I really don't want to butcher it. I'm going to find it before the end of the broadcast, though. I will, because I really want to verbally say it on here, read it properly, and give him his proper homage, because I was so impressed with him. But I've been impressed with him for a long time. Like I said, I've been a fan of Jeff Bezos for a long time. All right. So, next one. In this Caucasian corner of people I'm respecting right now, I got to tell you, in the Caucasian corner. Where is she? Ah, there she goes. All right. So, I don't know if you guys have heard about this. I'd like to give you guys updated news here as well. All right. So, this is going to be new information here for those of you who are not news whores like myself. I'm a news whore. The Seattle mayor, Jenny Durkin, says the Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone is patriotic, right? So, let me tell you what this is first, and then I'll tell you what she said. Let me explain to you what the Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone is. All right. Where is it? I'm fucking this up, aren't I? Okay, here we go. So protesters in Seattle, Washington have set up the Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone, known as CHAZ, as all cops in the area were booted out and have not been allowed back in. The zone is surrounded by blockades and roadblocks, with police claiming they have had reports of armed guards in patrolling the zone. It also includes the abandoned East Precinct, where cops were forced to flee after receiving threats it would be burned down. So people took to the streets and took over. Now, this is going to be a conversation in the coming weeks. I'm hearing a lot of people shouting and saying disband the police departments and this and that. I don't think human beings by nature, especially in this climate of sickness, economic strife and all, that can police themselves. And I'm not just saying that because I know I have law enforcement that listens to the show. I'm saying that because I don't think it's a good goddamn idea. It seems like the beginning of the Purge 3 or some shit. Doesn't seem right. But they do have a right to bear arms, according to the Constitution. They do have a right to protest and be peaceful. Because on all the pictures I'm seeing about this is peaceful. They got positive things they wrote in chalk on the ground and stuff like that. They're threatening to burn down a precinct, not the greatest thing to do. But, so in response to what was happening, the people and president, Trump, said that he was going to send in, you know, the army and all of this other stuff. Let me see what he's saying. Okay, so unfortunately, our president wants to tell a story about domestic terrorists who have a radical agenda and are promoting conspiracy that fits his law and order initiatives, right? This is what the Seattle mayor is saying. It's simply not true. Lawfully gathering and expressing First Amendment rights, demanding we do better as a society, and providing true equity for communities of color is not terrorism, it's patriotism. So Trump answered her back on Friday morning, tweeting, the Seattle mayor says about the anarchists taking over her city, it is the summer of love. These liberal Dems don't have a clue. The terrorists burn and pillage our cities, and they think it is just wonderful. Even the death must end. The Seattle takeover is now. Right? So her response, though, is not only is what they're doing legal, it's patriotic. And she's warning him that if he comes into her city with any military or anything else, that is illegal, and she will deal with him accordingly. So effectively, in her West Indian moment, as he's spewing his venom of dissension and division, she said effectively, look it, these people are peacefully here. They've done nothing wrong. And you effectively can go suck your mother. You can go suck your mother. Right? So effectively, I have decided that the Seattle mayor, Jenny Durkin, is officially West Indian for at least a week. Right? In the Caucasian corner, the Seattle mayor, Ms. Jenny Durkin, told the president of the United States for coming and trying to threaten to bully her in her city that she runs, that she got elected into, to go suck his mother. And I'm very proud of her, by the way. So in the Caucasian corner... Yes, talk radio, talk freaking radios, freaky fucking Fridays. The next song we're gonna play here this evening is going to be Fat Boy Shaw, Thinking About Ya, on Talk Radio's Freaky Fridays.
Pussy ass hoes got the game fucked up. Pussy ass niggas got the game fucked up. I see you telling them dog just to get your time cut.
You know,
what the fuck?
Go, Petty, go.
Look, long hair, yellow bone, pink pussy, two-tone. Took her to the Apple store and bought the bitch an iPhone.
You bought the bitch an iPhone?
Gotta know the time I'm on. Set you back a whole 3 hours, I can change the time zone. Bitch, I'm with the gang. Bitch, I'm in the mob. You ain't never did no time. How I know you won't tell the law? Fuck, I look like with some bitch. Don't know how to suck no dick like I was born with a pole, but I ain't never learned to fish. Like I'm big, like I'm small, like I'm fat, like I'm tall. Like my pussy face down, I let her head at the wall. I be beating in your bitch, trick or treating with your bitch. Might up and wife your hoe, just go to cheating on the bitch. Like when I get behind her, I'm a pumper. You know my pullout game, weak, ain't got no jumper. Look if them crackers get behind me, I'm gon' buck. So when I pull up, don't be acting like you ain't trying to fuck.
Man, I be drinking, I be driving, I be driving, I be drinking, I be smoking, I be thinking, I be thinking, I be thinking about fucking, 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 about. Man, I be drinking, I be driving, I be driving, I be drinking, I be smoking, I be thinking, I be thinking, I be thinking about fucking, 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 about.
Pussy ass hoes got the game fucked up. Pussy ass niggas got the game fucked up. I see you telling them dog just to get your time cut. What the fuck? Nah, hold up, wait a minute. Let me put some pimpin' in it. Red bone, bad bitch. What's your name? It's been a minute. What you sippin', girl? You trippin'? All the shit you see authentic. If you really look me up, you know I'm really fucking in it. Man, I be drinking, I be driving, I be driving, I be drinking, I be smoking, I be thinking, I be thinking, I be thinking about fucking, 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 about. Man, I be drinking, I be driving, I be driving, I be drinking, I be smoking, I be thinking, I be thinking, I be thinking about fucking, about fucking, about fucking.
Pussy ass niggas got the game fucked up. I see you telling them dog just to get your time cut. What the fuck?
TAWK Radio. Oh my god, www.TAWKradio.com/shows if you want to hear what's going on. We're available on Spotify, iHeart, Deezer, Podcast Chaser, Podcast Addict, and some other things. Always Google us, TAWK Radio. Look for the blue lips. We're all over the place. We want you guys to have access to us whenever you feel the need to. Share the link with your friends and stuff. So I think I'm finished with the Caucasian corner for this weekend. Shout out to Jeff Bezos and Miss Jenny Durkin, the mayor of Seattle, doing the damn thing and representing and just standing up for what you believe, right? You don't have to follow the fray. Stand up for what you personally believe in, right? That's the right thing to do. What was fire? The song? No. Everybody's sending me all kinds of things. 347-651-2468. Shout out to my big baby who is tuned into the show tonight. Being all naughty and grown and shit. I'm just saying, love you much. Love you much. Shout out to Mr. Davy Dingo. Jesus Christ. Davy Dingo in Phoenix, Arizona. I'm trying to see if I can dig back into these goddamn emails. Jumping back and forth all over the place. See, the thing is, I don't read these things until I'm live on the air. So as I'm clicking the things that catch my attention, the headlines, they're so long. And I'm not reading them. I'm not reading the goddamn stories. So I'm going to play another song while I dig around. And I'm going to come back on the other side, read two more emails, play some more songs, and finish off. We're going off around 10 o'clock. So tonight, we're going to continue here with two more independent artists here on Freaky Fridays. This one's called Cry by Bruckup here on Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio.
Cry for your body, make me see your boss away. Tell me say you love me, cause that's something they are my. Love you all night, no morning and sunshine.
That's why I can't stop, touch me, call me team right.
Cry for your body, make me see your boss away. Tell me say you love me, cause that's something they are my. Love you all night, no morning and sunshine.
That's why I can't stop, touch me, call me team right. My body nice, so hold me tight. Pussy don't like a jacket party all night.
You are feel me tight, belly not full of stripe.
I saw me fling it on the left,
me put it on the right. I cry, me I cry for your body, girl. Anyway you see me, you feel give me, girl. Take the touch,
so me a bubble up.
Force it up, me know you like the thing rough. Come make me wind up in your love. And then just out on the floor, me a give you love.
More wire, force it in a me love. In a the bed, me a wine in a wiggle love.
Cry for your body, make me see your boss away. Tell me say you love me, cause that's something they are my. Love you all night, no morning and sunshine.
That's why I can't stop, touch me, call me team right.
Cry for your body, make me see your boss away. Tell me say you love me, cause that's something they are my. Love you all night, no morning and sunshine.
That's why I can't stop, touch me, call me team right.
Tell me nah rush, that's something they squeeze up. Wind up your body, me know why you ease up.
Why me want touch that love in your brain, look. Give it to me, I mean no why you ease up.
So baby take your time, bend your back and then your way. Make your ball all night until the sunshine. Take the touch,
so me a bubble up.
Force it up, me know you like the thing rough. Cry for your body, make me see your boss away. Tell me say you love me, cause that's something they are my. Love you all night, no morning and sunshine.
That's why I can't stop, touch me, call me team right.
Cry for your body, make me see your boss away. Tell me say you love me, cause that's something they are my. Love you all night, no morning and sunshine.
That's why I can't stop, touch me, call me team right. My body nice, so hold me tight. Pussy don't like a jacket party all night.
You are feel me tight, belly not full of stripe.
I saw me fling it on the left,
me put it on the right. I cry for your body, girl. Anyway you see me, you feel give me, girl. Take the touch,
so me a bubble up.
Force it up, me know you like the thing rough. Come make me wind up in your love. And then just out to the floor, me a give you love.
More wire, force it in a me love. In a the bed, me a wine in a wiggle love.
Cry for your body, make me see your boss away. Tell me say you love me, cause that's something they are my. Love you all night, no morning and sunshine.
That's why I can't stop, touch me, call me team right.
Cry for your body, make me see your boss away. Tell me say you love me, cause that's something they are my. Love you all night, no morning and sunshine.
That's why I can't stop, touch me, call me team right.
I cry for your body, girl.
TAWKRadio.com/shows, www.TAWKRadio.com/shows. Freaky fucking Friday on the side of the road in New York City. All right, so next email coming in. My rainbow community is on fire tonight. Is talking to men an indication of being gay? Huh. Okay, let's find out. I talk to men all the time and I don't think I'm gay. I'm being an asshole right now. I know that I like women a lot. What's been troubling me is guys. Aside from watching gay porn a lot, I also have actually gone on dating sites many times and talked to a lot of guys. Some of those convos even got serious. Plus, I almost met a few, but I got nervous about the idea of actually meeting them and the thought I could actually be gay. So should I meet someone, and is the whole thing of flirting with men online more than just curious? Yeah. So it seems as though, well, okay. So your curiosity, you wouldn't know until you get to act it out. Now here's the thing, if you're watching, interesting. Because I've watched gay porn before. I have. I was curious about it. I watched it. It's interesting. Kind of see what the whole big deal was about, because I have a lot of gay friends and gay fans who feel like, you know, they could take away anybody I was ever dating because their head game is better than mine, or their waist game is better than mine, or whatever. I think it's a bag of bullshit personally, but you know, hey, I think this one I get in with whoever I'm messing with. But let's just go there. If you're a guy and you're watching gay porn and you're getting off to it, there are some homosexual tendencies there, I think. But then you went past the point, because you know your brain does what it does, your body does what it does. But if you're taking it to a point where now you're interacting with actors, see, porn stars are exactly what they are. They are actors, right? So it's kind of like you look at a movie and you say, okay, I'm not going to get to sleep with Samuel L. Jackson. He's a movie star. I might not run into him. It's not very likely. So it's kind of like a fantasy, it's a thing, it's a whatever. But if you're then extending this to a situation where you can run into these people and meet these people, it seems as though you're closeted and angry about it, because you're like, oh, the thought of you being gay freaks you out. But it seems as though you are. Maybe come on out the closet. You don't have to look it. I don't know why people are under the misconception that when you come out of the closet, there has to be a whole fucking parade for you. People don't need to know what your sexual proclivities are or preferences are unless they're fucking you. You don't have to walk around with a sign and a banner that says, I like sucking dick, or I like getting fucked in the ass. That's not a thing. But coming out of the closet simply means that you're owning your truth, and now you can take time to find and interact with the people that you'd like to interact with. My rainbow community can feel free to jump in and help me if you're so inclined to do so, or anybody else. 347-651-2468. 347-651-2468. This is Freaky Fucking Fridays with your hostess, Cypher Kai, here on TAWK Radio. We're going to get into... we're missing anything? Yep. So, we have one more independent artist song, and then, like I said, we're going to finish the evening off with a very, very grown-up throwback from 1986 that was a special request this evening. And I like to do special requests from time to time. What are you guys saying in here? There's so much conversations happening in this public chat room. I love you guys so much. What is happening? I'm hearing some sounds that sound like gunshots, but Lord knows, I am hoping that it is fireworks instead. Another good song. I'm glad you guys are liking the music. I do. Oh, do you make good products? Yeah. Fine. All you need is a Mac. Billy G about to take over. Ech. No, Billy G can suck a egg. You're talking about Bill Gates, aren't you? He can suck something. Anyway, this next one on Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio is Chapter 9's Bin Bad Priority. Bin Bad Rhythm Bad Priority here on Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio.
I'm the big vice, big tune, bad artist. I'm the big vice, big tune, bad artist. I'm the big vice, big tune, bad artist. Yo. Oh, no, I say them hype. True, them have a one house and them have a one car and I ride a big bike. But them other day a country I use cold stove and still I use candlelight. Them priority no right, them a floss in a night and broke in a daylight. Look at who them
them a say wife so much you long pipe. Now fi take off the stripe. One, some boy no fi live long car. Them a live wrong, me a fi sing me song. Two, I me no business a who from you a move blue bun you and your crew. Three, could a never pay a school fee, but them in a dance all pamper laughing spree. Four, me see the cap poor pan floor, but your mother dey a country a sleep out a door. Five, them boy they no fi survive, me no in a that, them pitney them a deprive. Six, them a go lose like the Knicks vote out, but this a no politics. Them a say them hype, true them have a one house and them have a one car and a ride a big bike. But them other than your country, I use coal stove and still I use candlelight. Priority no right, them a floss in a night and broke in a daylight. Look at who them a say wife, some old she long pipe, me fi take off the stripe. Yeah, me know them, me know the type, ever clean, ever bossy, them ever hype. Look into this, like is a sniper, we sniper woman, fi a live like him, nah no life. He hurt me, like is a baby, we gripe, miserable, angry, like me want fi fight. No progression, dirty Israelite, vagabond, what a man, yeah, him do it fi spite. Make me rebuke them with all me might. Watch them a scatter light, them a scatter light. Don't come with me there, don't even try it. Fi bun them, yeah, me have a right. Them a say them hype, true them have a one house and them have a one car and a ride a big bike. But them a dad they a country, I use coal stove and still I use candlelight. Priority no right, them a floss in a night and broke in a daylight. Look at who them a say wife, some old she long pipe, me a fi take off the stripe. One, some boy no fi live long car, them a live wrong, me a fi sing me song. Two, I me no business a who from you a move blue gun you and your crew. Three, could a never pay a school fee, but them in a dance all pamper laughing spree. Four, me see lick a poor pan floor, but your mother dey a country a sleep out a door. Five, them boy they no fi survive, me no in a that, them pitney them a deprive. Six, them a go lose like the Knicks vote out, but this a no politics. Them a say them hype, true them have a one house and them have a one car and a ride a big bike. But them a dad they a country and use coal stove and still a use candlelight. Priority no right, them a floss in a night and broke in a daylight. Look at who them a say wife, some old she long pipe, me a fi take off the stripe.
TAWK Radio, TAWK Radio. To those of you who are concerned, because I am parked outside and this microphone is picking up everything, it is fireworks. I know that because as I'm hearing the popping sounds, I can see the little, you know, the colorful popping out of it. I think it's called like a Roman candle or something. So it is fireworks. It's absolutely fireworks. All right. And I'm in a very posh area, so I'm sure I'll be fine. You guys pray for me anyway, but I'm sure I'll be fine. But it is fireworks. Like I said, I can see the rainbow coloring coming out of it. So we're going to finish this evening off with this email here. It says, my girlfriend lost her shit and emailed my wife details. Ooh. See, that's where you fucked up right there. You shouldn't have a wife and a girlfriend anyway. Well, let's see what you're talking about here. Ooh. Here's the email my girlfriend sent to my wife. Oh my God. She also included about eight pictures of us together. What should I do? What would you do to her, the girlfriend? Hi, hun. I was in town visiting XX from August such and such to August such and such. He asked me to come to the park with you guys on Sunday so I could see your son on the rides. But don't worry, I didn't. I stayed in a different part of the park until you guys were done. We went to the beach on Sunday night and came back on Wednesday. We stayed in a really nice place in the beach. He showed me the house you guys almost brought and also his client's golf course, which was a racetrack once. So cool. We also went to the beach, of course, and it was so nice. He proposed to me on the beach and promised that he filed for divorce from you, but I don't think he has anymore. He said that he didn't want to go through a lawyer because it would be too expensive and he needs the money for his business that you invested in. Can you tell me what's going on with you guys? He also said you guys don't sleep together since January either, but I don't believe him anymore. We saw each other the other day after your anniversary in May, and he said you went to dinner and that's all. I don't believe him anymore. He also called me from the movie theater this weekend from the concession stand because you made him leave his phone at home. I just don't want to be played anymore. I don't know what he wants, and I think he's telling us different things. Motherfucker. Ooh, woo. Look it. See, this is why... why I authentically read these fucking emails. Okay, look, Jesus. Give me a minute, you guys. Give me a fucking minute. This is live radio. Give me a fucking minute. So, this is why I give you guys instructions to get papers and pens. If this... See, clearly the person that sent this in... What is his name? Baron, you're clearly not a talker. You found the platform. You sent me the email. I appreciate it. But you're clearly not a talker. And your side bitch was not trained. She was not trained. And that's your fault. You're supposed to train her with your cock. Clearly your dick is garbage. And you didn't train this bitch. Let me tell you why I know that. Right? First of all, you raggedy fucker. And I'm going to curse you out. And still appreciate you and want you to come back and listen to the show another time. Right? This woman has too much access to your wife. I'm going to give you a minute to meditate on that shit for a second. This woman has too much access to your wife. That's an absolute no-no. Side bitches are never supposed to have access to your wife. Let me tell you how deep this shit's supposed to be. Even if you are fucking a female in law enforcement. If you are fucking a female FBI agent, she should still never have access to your wife. Point blank, period. Secondly, your cock is garbage. Let me tell you how I know that definitively. Yes? Because when women, because we outnumber you guys like 9-1 globally, when a woman gets a good fuck, right? She will do whatever she's required to do to not lose said fuck. Give you a minute with that one as well. So your cock is garbage. Three. You got careless at some point. Besides the fact that this woman has access to your wife, you've done something different, something careless, however slight it is, to make this side woman feel like she's on the same level with your wife and that she had the right to reach out to her this way. And this was calculated. And this was very, very vindictive. So the question you have for me is, what the fuck to do with the girlfriend? Get rid of the girlfriend. Also divorce the wife, because I can't imagine she would keep you after this. And if she did, I wouldn't trust her. I wouldn't eat from her again. I wouldn't fuck her. None of that. I wouldn't trust her. And not because she did something wrong, because you did something wrong. This is not just you cheating. This is you disrespecting everything you've had with your wife. You allowed this side bitch not only access to her, but detailed information to hurt her. This woman, this email is filled with razor blades with salt on them. She let your wife know that you had her around your child. She let your wife know that she hung out with you after your anniversary. She let your wife know that even when she tried to stop this reckless behavior you were engaging in, even without a phone, you went to a public phone to call her. This was an email full of razor blades and salt, you careless fucker. Like, seriously? What advice did you want me to give you? Like, I would literally tell you to go jump over something really high and quickly, but you might actually do it. I don't want to have that on my conscience. But what the whole entire fuck? I'm going to give you homework as well. I need you to go back and listen to, damn it, every episode of Talk Radio that's available for public consumption. Particularly, Learning to Be Stingy with Your Dick Part 2. And a couple other ones that I'm sure I gave some kind of really explicit instructions as to how you're supposed to train your side chicks. And clearly, I'm going to have to make a series out of this because you guys are not getting the picture. You're not getting the picture. You are a wretched... Oy. I thank you for being a talker, but just because you are doesn't mean I won't curse you out. I say this with as much love as I possibly can. No respect, but a lot of love for you. That you felt, knowing what you might get from me, you still sent the email in anyway. So I appreciate that about you, but you need to dump that bitch. You need to divorce your wife and set her free from your nonsense. You just got a lot of shit happening. You got a lot of shit happening. What is all this stuff I'm missing? Oh my God. I miss a lot of things in this public chat room. You guys are very busy tonight. All right. So yeah. I do have a security detail. Oh God. I do. Thank you, Mr. Venn. Why don't I run for president? Are you serious? You gotta be kidding me. Yeah, I hope it's... So somebody's, Mr. Ben says in the chat room, and this is a guy saying this, a guy is saying, I hope your wife takes you for everything you got because you're a dumbass. He is a dumbass. He really is a dumbass. I'm not going to run for president ever. He's not president of a country. President of a corporation, maybe, not a country. No, I didn't ask for anything. Good God. Anyway, we're going to wind down the show this evening with that throwback from 1986. This one is going out to Miss Donna. I don't know if she's listening live, if she's listening to the archive, or how that's going to work out. But this one is a throwback 1986 grown-ass throwback. This one is Shirley Murdoch's As We Lay from 1986. Talk Radio's Freaky Fucking Fridays.
Whoa!
TAWK Radio's Freaky Fucking Fridays. This has been another episode of www.tawkradio.com/shows, episodes of Freaky Friday with Cypher Kai. You guys have been amazing. This is the Email Extravaganza Part 5. We'll be doing this, you know, once a month. I think I'll do it once a month. We'll just dig into the email bags until, of course, we get the phone lines open back and you guys can call in with all your debauchery live. If you want to text me directly for any feedback or commentary on anything you heard live or in these archives, from since this number has become active, go back. I think there's like 40 episodes of archives available on the website and all over the place. 347-651-2468. 347-651-2468. And you guys can leave me information back and forth there, of course. Keep it. I still can't believe someone said I should run for president. That's so cute. First of all, I don't think I'd pass the clearance. I've been a very bad girl. Even when I'm not on there, I've been a very bad girl. I don't think I would pass the clearance. But then again, you know, if look what we got there now. I don't know that, like I said, I don't know that I want to be the president of a country, maybe a corporation or so, but not really a country. I don't know. I don't think so. Shout out to Anthony the Lyft driver, who will be listening in the archives, letting me know that he went on a great fishing trip in Montauk, New York, and didn't take me. You bum. I'm calling you out on the show. Thank you to Miss Blue Ayara, who's hanging out. She has a wonderful book in Amazon, you guys, called It Started in Brooklyn. Go and check that out, purchase it, support her. Go onto her social media pages and tag at Talk Radio under it. Thank you, Mr. Ware. Thank you, Mr. Ven. Oh, my oldest was hanging out in the chat room today as well. Shout out to Baby Girl, who is grown, Baby Girl. Like, you know, she's a grown woman. She was hanging out today too with her girlfriend, tuned into the show. Shout out to my rainbow community. Shout out to everybody who is divinely connected to and tuned in. Shout out to all of the sponsors. Tonight it wasn't about you guys, but you know we love you. There will be another musical mix at 6 on Monday. Not doing one this weekend, but there will be another one on Monday, you guys. And of course, next week, let me tell you what the topic is next week. Next week is going to be a very explosive show. The entire show. I don't think we're doing any headline news next week unless it pertains directly to the topic. So next week we're going to be talking about, for people, I was going to say women only, but for people who lie about being raped, people who falsely accuse people of raping them, should they also be brought up on charges when it's proven that they lied? Should they be convicted for lying about being raped? That hits me on like three different levels, three different angles, three different dimensions. I can't imagine I'm going to say anything that's not profane next week as I start talking about that topic. It's so, so personal to me for so many reasons. And you guys, like I said, you know I don't keep any secrets from you. So I will tell you all of my business and we'll talk like we're grown for that episode. So I want all my law enforcement to tune in, all the women to tune in. If you've been a rape victim, if you've been accused of this before, even if you weren't convicted and it just caused some ruckus in your house, we're going to have a very, very thorough conversation about this because it is personal to me. Yes, so we're going to discuss this next week in depth on Talk Radio's episode of Freaky Fucking Fridays. I will see you guys on Monday by God's grace. Have a great night and a great weekend, you guys.